Mitra Ghosh. So she's the Secretary General of Indian Public Health Association, who has having a membership of over 15,000, served as Chief Medical Officer in Ministry of Defense, and got a prestigious award, Indian Medical Association's Dr. Kanak Goyal Award for his commendable work in family planning and health work in 2014. She has got immense experience in the field of gynecology and actively involved in the field of public health for so many years. She has got lot number of publications in national as well as international journals. So madam, you have been a secretary general for 2 tenures now of a association which is the longest, the largest association of public health, not only in India, but also abroad. So how do you have ensured that your association has played a dominant role in managing corona?
Thank you, Dr. Sanu. First of all, namaste to all. I heard all of your lectures and all discussion in this forum, and it is marvelous. We have heard Dr. V.K. Pal. So about your question for our association, you know our association has unique membership criteria that not only the doctors, we have nursing officers and social worker, health workers, they are also our members. So all these members in other states, they are working for the corona prevention. First of all, from the headquarter, we have been invited from PMO and in Niti Aayog for participation in the policy making of the COVID-19 prevention. And the meetings are virtual, and it was attended by our president, Dr. Sanjay Rai. And we are in the policy making. We are with the government and we are doing the awareness program, and we are increasing the capacity building. That capacity building is our main aim now. And in for that, we have first in 17th March, we gave a public advisory for all the public and for our members for the COVID-19 prevention. And there only we first mentioned that this is not social distancing, it's just physical distancing. And we gave 3 points. For one is that cough etiquette, second is social distancing, and third is source containment. And after that, we have changed our public advisory as and when, as sir has said, that we don't know about this virus. Every day we are gaining knowledge about this virus, and it has played havoc in all the countries. So in here also, we are gaining knowledge, and all the prediction models are not proving true, makes maximum time. So we also had some mathematical prediction model, but that is not proving true. But we have gained some time with the government's lockdown, that we certainly we increase the infrastructure, health infrastructure, betterment of the health infrastructure, and we are with the government. Like government has asked for members list from the different state. That we have sent already, because we have members in all the states. Our members in different states, they are working as state level nodal officer, senior nodal officers, and our different public health leaders, they are working with the central team in different state. Like we can you must be knowing that NICED, National Institute of Enteric and Cholera and Enteric Disease, and then All India Institute of Hygiene and Public Health, all the professor and professor director, they have been selected, and they are going to different state to see the epidemic state and is there any gap.
Dr. Sangmitra, I think a lot of things have been done. You have really highlighted that association has played a very dominant role in managing the corona and in real coordination with center and various states. So the similar question to this is, how have you ensured linkages at different levels, and how do you perceive the change role of association in the future?
Obviously, this is mostly virtual, always. And in our state level, in our headquarter level also, our headquarter staffs are working from home, and we are also, some of them are working from home. Yeah. And we are going to publish one of the Corona COVID-19 special issue for our journal. So yeah. All our meetings are virtual. Somebody is in Delhi, somebody is in Maharashtra, Pune, Mumbai, and everywhere. Even our publisher in Mumbai. So we are always in virtual and in the social media. Yeah. And actually, I have given so many interviews all from my home to the BBC, to Akashvani Radio, and to all of the TV channels. So these are all virtual. And yeah. We are connected with all our members from our website and online only.
Wonderful. So I think IPHA is playing like IAPSM, as IPHA and IAPSM are both public health associations playing a very dominant role in this COVID era. And I hope that they will continue playing the similar role, and they will have an even bigger role in the future if the corona pandemic strikes.
Obviously, because our scientist members, they are in the testing and the vaccine, in the virology lab and in the vaccine development. So we hope that a future vaccine will come, because we will live with this virus mostly. Yeah. And the peak will come in different state in different time. For this year will be like this, and all our conferences and all the everything will be virtual. Probably the national conference also. And we are connected with our World Federation of Public Health, which we are the member. And the World Federation, you know very well that the World Federation conference was is in October in Rome, going to be held in Rome, but it is cancelled and it will be a virtual conference. So it is a new normal thing.
Okay, thank you, Dr. Sangmitra. I think thank you for your kind words, and I hope that I am saying that public health associations should play a dominant role in this corona